morning everyone. We are going to study lesson 7 and the name is The Library. This poem is written by John Greenleaf. White Tear. The Library is written by John Greenleaf Whittier. This poem we are going to study. Today we are having two classes. Every day we are having two classes except Wednesday. So after this period also you join. Go to page number 61. You see library. So in our school also library is there. In library what used to be there? Collection of books. Okay, collection of so many different book used to be there. And children can find the book according to their interest and they can study. Right. About the author we can get information in page number 63. So John Greenleaf Whittier, he was born in the year 1807 and died in the year 1892. Can you tell me, children, how many years he lived on earth? Who is good in mathematics? Who can say this answer? Seventh standard children, if he is born in 1807 and died in 1892, how many years he lived on earth? Who will say this answer?
85 years.
Okay. So 85 years. Yes, correct answer. 92 minus 7. 85. He lived a life of 85 years. He was American poet. Means he was born in which country? America. So he is American poet and editor. He is poet also and he is editor also. Means he is writing in the newspaper. Okay, he is editing the newspaper. A deeply committed activist. Activist means the one who used to care about society and the one who used to take a stand on the social issue is called activist. He was a leading advocate of the abolition of slavery in the United States. Okay, leading advocate. So, advocate means don't think the one who has studied law and who is working in the court, he is only advocate. Here means he was activist and he was talking so many points that why the slavery should banned all over the world, okay, especially in United States, because he was belonging from that place.
Sir, there is 1892.
Yes, on the board also it is 1892. Let me zoom it.
No.
Okay, let me zoom it more. Can you see?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, I think on board I should not write 9 like that. I should write like this. Now it is fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, this much information about the writer we all can remember. Children, library used to be the place where so many books are present, okay. Now it depends on the reader that what he want to read, what he want to study. For example, someone is interested to read newspaper only in the library, every day in the library newspaper used to be there, and he is only interested to read the sports page. Someone is interested to read the comic book, okay, in which children's stories are there, funny stories are there. Someone is interested to read some horror stories. Someone is interested to read about science, physics, okay. Someone is interested to read literature. Like this, in library, it depends on you that what you want to study. And children don't leave the class in between, because when you leave the class, on the mobile phone it is showing that this child left the class. This video is recorded, which you can see on the YouTube also, and this video every day is linked in the pocket also. So when so many other children, so many other teachers including me, we will see, we will understand this child left the class. Every day this child used to leave the class, right? So this is not good impression. Network issue can be one day. Network issue cannot be every day. And you see, every day network issue cannot be there, because all other children are able to take the class. Why you are only leaving the class every day? If you are joining the class for attendance, then it is bad thing, it is wrong thing. You should join the class to study. So starting the poem now, page number 61, you see, what this poem title, What is a Book, by Laura Dodd. A book is pages, pictures and words. A book is animals, people and birds. A book is the stories of queens and kings, poems and song, so many things. Curled in a corner where I can hide, with a book I can journey far and wide. Thou its only paper from end to end, a book is a very special friend. So this is written by Dot, and what she is explaining, she is explaining that what is called a book. Having pages, pictures, words. A book is having animals, people and birds, stories of queen and king, poem and song. Like this, the information here is provided about the book, that what the book used to be. Now you can turn to the page number 62. And then you see, let there be light, exclamation mark. God spake of old, and over chalks dark and cold, and thou the deeds and formless frame, cave. So what this four line is saying, let there be light, exclamation mark. First of all, what should be there? Light should be there. God speak of old, and God used to talk about what? Old means from the beginning, and over chaos, dark and cold means when nothing was there, whole universe was not created. Completely it was dark and cold, means sun was also not there, so they are saying cold it was and dark it was. And through the dead and formless frame, dead and formless frame, because no life is there, nothing is there, universe is only not existing, so dead and formless frame, nature, life and order came. So everything started from there, okay, nature, life, order. See the next stanza. Faint was the light at first that shone. So first time the light which was shown, that was not bright light, that was faint light. You know children, what is the meaning of faint light?
No, sir.
Okay. F-A-I-N-T, faint light. The light which is dim, D-I-M-D, dim light, that is called faint light. The light which is dim is called faint light. So first the light which the God showed to everyone, to the universe, that was dim on Jan Ferdinand Mastodon. So where he showed, you see, a large extinct elephant like mammal of ancient time. So first time the light was shown and the creature was here, who was looking like elephant, okay, mammal she was. Mammal means those who can give birth to young ones, okay, they are called mammal. On half formed plant and beast of prey. So like this only, half formed plant and beast of prey. So like this wild animals, they are also created. Prey means those who can attack and they can eat, they can depend on them. And man as rude and wild as they. And how God has created human being? God has created human being, how the human beings are. So human beings are rude, wild and good also. But here it is written that God has created human being, rude and wild, how they are. Right. So children, here I want to say that being rude, being wild is our choice. This is our choice. Why this is our choice? Because God has given willpower to us. And by giving willpower, God said that now you can decide what you have to do. And brain also he has given. You can think what you are going to do and what the result you may get in future. Okay. So I can say one thing, that God loves us very much. So God has given us freedom, that you decide, you do. This is your life. Okay. But if you are intelligent, you will never do bad thing. If you are foolish, then you will face a lot of problem. Are you able to understand, children? So if we are polite, if we are civilized, this is our choice. Okay? And this is the good way to live a good life. This is the good way to live a good life. age after age, like waves, O Iran, the earth uplifting brute and man. So age after age, what started happening? Age after age, like waves, how in the water body waves used to be there. Okay, have you seen wave? Like this water body is there, so like this wave is coming. How the wave used to come? Okay, regular. And because these waves are going sometime very maximum, they are called tide also, high tide, low tide. Think on this topic. So after age, like waves, O Iran, the earth uplifting brute and man. Uplifting means the earth started uplifting, means having, okay, animal and human beings, beast and human beings together. Now the population of the world is nearly 700 crore. How many children? 700 crore. Means 700 crore people and so many animals, so many birds, they are present on the earth. So earth is upholding all these people, bird, animal and other creatures. Okay. And then you see next one, next line. And mind, at length, in symbols, dark, its meaning traced on stone and bark. If you are talking about mind, and if you want to see the symbol, what you can go, you can find out the meaning which are on the stone also and which are present on the bark of the tree also. Both places, what you can do, you can find out the meanings. Okay, now you can see the next line, what the next line is saying. On leaf of palm, on such rock wool, on plastic clay and lithium scroll, man wrote his thought in the ages past, and lo, the press was found at last. Means this is the age how the development came. First, the human being, they were writing on the palm, okay, palm leaf. Okay. Then they started, before that they were writing on the stones. Okay. So like this, people started writing their information and knowledge at different places, and the printing press was formed at last. Right. This is humorous and interesting. So next stanza, you see, then dead soul woke, dead soul woke, the thoughts of men whose bones were dust revived again, the cloister silence found a tongue, old prophets spake, old poets sung. So this line is saying that again the dead soul is awaking, means people are becoming more alert regarding the spiritual thing, regarding the knowledge. Okay. And they started finding out that what is truth. So you can see revive, regain life or strength. The cloister silent found a tongue, means that time the truth was silent, you can see. A covered walk in a religious institution, and they found that old prophet spake, old poet sung. So prophet regarded as inspired teacher or proclaimers of the will of so many prophets came to the world, right? Like you can say the name also, like Lord Krishna, Lord Rama, okay. And then you can say Jesus Christ, Prophet Muhammad. So they all are called prophet, okay? They all are called prophet. Because they said that they were saying whatever the thing according to the will of God, right? So till here you can mark children, and in next class we will do the writing section also, and we will discuss some more stanza. Thank you all children for listening. Have a good day.